If I ask you, where would you find a black hole in our galaxy? I am sure you will point to the center of the Milky Way. This is the place where the supermassive black hole, Sagittarius A, resides. But have you ever wondered whether there are many more black holes existing in other parts of our galaxy? If yes, then why haven't we found them yet? What is it that we are still missing? Are you sure we even understand some basic things about black holes? In this video, you are going to meet a new breed of black holes. The theory of general relativity proposed by Albert Einstein brought a revolution in physics and astronomy. This was the first scientific theory which had predicted the existence of black holes in our universe. Then almost a century later, scientists and astronomers were able to detect the first black hole, Cygnus X1. It is located in the Cygnus constellation. Then we discovered the supermassive black hole at the center of our galaxy. All the black holes we have discovered so far have a common feature which has helped us to easily find them. They are highly active, constantly emitting radio waves and X-rays. These black holes continuously feed on the nearby astronomical objects and emit radiation such as X-rays and radio waves. And due to their powerful radiation signatures, we have easily located them. We can detect their presence because they are highly active and continuously emit radiations. So the question arises, do all black holes emit radiation? Recently, a group of international scientists were closely observing the stars of Tarantula Nebula. On the 18th of July this year, they discovered a blue star rapidly orbiting an unknown object. To their surprise and amazement, they couldn't find its companion star. There was no sign of it. Then, after continuous observations, the data showed that there must be a massive object present there, which is not emitting any form of radiation. The object couldn't be a star, because we couldn't find one. It couldn't be a planet or any solid object, because the star's light would have reflected from its surface. So there is only one object which is massive enough to gravitationally bind a blue star in its orbit and remain practically invisible. It must be a black hole. So the findings suggested that there is a black hole around which this blue star is rapidly orbiting. After further investigations, it was confirmed that it is a dormant black hole. This star and the black hole are in a binary system, which means they orbit a common center of gravity. This finding revealed that black holes could be really silent. They need not emit energy and radiation all the time. The number of this type of black holes could be hundreds of millions in our own galaxy. There is much to learn and understand about the nature of these black holes. This is the first dormant black hole we have discovered so far. And the intriguing thing is that they are extremely difficult to detect. They do not emit any energy or radiation. We can only detect them by their gravitational effects on nearby astronomical objects. The name of this dormant black hole is VFTS 243. Its mass is about 9 times the mass of the Sun, but its diameter is around 33 miles or 54 kilometers. The strange thing is that this black hole was not created in a supernova explosion. If it was created in a supernova, then it would have ejected the blue star from its orbit. So it indicates that its progenitor star must have died without any explosion. This is strange, considering the fact that the star was heavy enough to transform into a black hole, yet so light that it collapsed without any explosion. This raises the question about how much we understand stellar evolution and the life of a star. I am here to share with you all the latest discoveries about the cosmos. So don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching.